So let's take a look at problem-solving in ancient Egypt. One of the oldest problems in mathematics, from the Rhine Papyrus, is the following. A number and its seventh make 19. Find the number. To solve this problem, Ahmos wrote down three multiplication tables. We'll put those down here. And again, note that the material that we placed in the brackets is not part of the actual text, but it's material that makes the text a little bit more comprehensible. And so the important question is, how should we interpret this? Well, let's take a look at this first multiplication table. So we know the problem is that a number and its seventh make 19. So notice here that Ahmos has taken a number, found its seventh, and presumably added them together. And so we might read this first table as, we guessed 7, we took its 7th, and together we found 8. In other words, we guessed a solution, and if we're fantastically lucky, it would actually be the solution. But it's not. We might look at the result as follows. We got a total of 8, but we wanted to get 19. So, how much do we need to scale our guess by? Well, it's whatever we need to multiply 8 by to get 19. And that's where this second multiplication table comes in. This is, what do we need to multiply 8 by to get 19? And so we find that we need to multiply our guess by 2, a quarter, and an eighth. And so that means we need to find 7 times 2, a quarter, and an eighth. And so that's our last multiplication table, 2, a quarter, and an eighth, multiplied by 7. Which gives us our answer, 16, a half, and an eighth. Now, Ahmos does many examples of this type of problem, and in the text, this approach is usually accompanied with the word aha, which means, no, it's not the name of a Norwegian band. The word in ancient Egyptian actually refers to heap. And in modern terms, what Ahmos is doing is using a form of proportional reasoning called single false position. And that works in modern terms as follows. We guess a solution, see if it works, and if it doesn't, we'll scale it by an appropriate factor. So, for example, a quantity and its half make 16. Let's find the quantity. So, our method of single false position starts off by guessing a solution. And so we guess a solution, and the only restriction on this guess is that it should be something we can take half of. So let's guess, how about 8? So we're supposed to take the quantity and its half, so let's take the quantity, that's 8, half of the quantity, that's 4, and so together, the quantity and its half make 12. Now, if we were fantastically lucky, or an extremely good guesser, we could have guessed the actual solution, but we didn't. Our guess of 8 only gave us 12, but we wanted 16. So we need to scale our guess. And the question you got to ask yourself is, what times 12 makes 16? So we'll form that multiplication table for 12. So 1 gets us 12. We want to make 16, so we'll take the aliquot part 1/3. Now we have the pieces we need. And so that tells us 1 1/3 times 12 makes 16. And this gives us our scaling factor, 1 1/3. And so now we multiply our guess by this scaling factor. Now we could either take 8 1 1/3 or 1 1/3 8. But it'll generally be easier to multiply our fractional amounts. So we'll start with 1 1/3, then double it a few times. And since we actually wanted 8 1/3, our product will just be this last row. And that gives us our solution, 10 2/3. Or how about a number? Its half and its third make 13. Find the number. So we guess, whatever we guess, it's got to be something we're willing to take half and a third of. So let's guess 6. So we have our number, we find half and a third, And so the number, its half, and its third make 13. 11, not 13. So again, if we're fantastically lucky, we might have actually guessed the solution, but we probably won't. But that's okay, because we can scale our guess. It's helpful to think about this in the following way. Our guess got us 11, but we wanted to make 13. And so the next question we have to ask ourselves is, what times 11 makes 13? In other words, what do we have to multiply our result by to get what we want? So let's answer that question. We'll form a table of multiples of 11. The only aliquot part is the 11th. We can double the 11th by looking up our 2 over n table. That turns out to be 1/6, 1/66. And to make 13, we'll need these two pieces. And so the way to read this is if we multiply our result 11 by 1, a 6th, and a 66th, we'll get 13, which is what we want to make. And so that means we want to multiply our guess by this amount. So we'll form a table of multiples of 1, 1/6, 1/66. We'll double. We'll double again. And we used our table again to find the double of 1/33. Since we want 6 times, we'll take the 2 and the 4, and that gives us our answer. And so our solution is 7, a 22nd, a 33rd, and a 66th.